स्मार्ट चार्ट पाई चार्ट। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट पाई चार्ट। गुड मॉर्निंग किड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल?
वी आर गुड।
डॉक्टर अंकल, व्हाट इज दिस ऑन द वॉल्स ऑफ योर रूम?
Through these charts, we get an idea which disease has caused trouble to most kids of our school in this month.
How?
Okay, let me explain. This month, fever, cold, and indigestion has caused a lot of trouble to you children. I have represented the data in this form.
Yes, yes, this is called a table.
Absolutely right. Now look at this data in another form.
I will tell. This is pictograph.
Very good. Can you tell me which chart is this?
Yes, this is strip chart.
Very good. Kids, you all know about various types of charts. Do you know about pie chart?
No, Dr. Uncle.
So the chart you are seeing on this wall is known as pie chart. Come, let's learn about this. Today we have learnt, what is pie chart? Pie chart. Examples of pie chart. Today you will learn about what is a pie chart and how to find data from a pie chart. So kids, this round-shaped chart you are looking at is known as pie chart.
Is it because it is round like a pie?
Yes. Can you tell what is this chart representing?
This chart represents which disease has troubled most of the kids.
Very good. As you can see in the chart, number of children who got sick due to cold are represented by red color. Number of children who got sick due to fever are represented by blue. And the number of children who got sick due to indigestion are represented by green color.
Doctor Uncle, most of the children had cold.
Right. And the least number of students were affected by which disease?
Indigestion. Yesterday only I got sick due to indigestion.
Oh, are you okay now?
Yes.
Come, let's look at some more examples. This is a prayer plate. In this, flowers and fruits are kept in this way. If the priest offers all the flowers to the god, how much part of the plate will remain empty?
Half.
Absolutely correct. And if this much fruit is given in the prasad, then how much full will the plate remain?
1/4 fruits remain.
Very good. Now let's look upon more examples. This pie chart shows how many students came to class today. If total strength of the class is 20, then how many students are absent today?
These are the present kids and these are the absent kids.
Here we'll find out 1/4 of 20. Because absent kids are 1/4 of the total chart. So 1/4 of 20 will be, half of 20 is 10 and half of 10 is 5. So total 5 students are absent today.
Very good. Now let's look at one more example. Now all of you, look at this chart and think if there are half boys and half girls in a class, and the number of boys is 10, then what will be the number of girls?
10.
Right. So what is the total number of students in the class?
10 and 10, it's 20.
Very good. So kids, today you have learnt about what is a pie chart and how to find data from a pie chart. Smart chart, pie chart. In this video, we will know about some common misconceptions related to pie chart. Sometimes, we consider 1/4 and 3/4 to be equal while calculating. Is this a right belief? First, tell me which is more, 1/4 of potatoes or 3/4 of potatoes?
3/4.
Right answer. Kids, do you know we can write quarter as 1/4 too?
Yes, Dr. Uncle.
So, now can you tell me how to write 3/4?
3/4, is it right?
Absolutely right. Now, look at this 4 same sized wood logs. Now, can you guess their different numbers in relation to this 4 woods?
This is 1/4.
This is 3/4.
This is 2/4.
This is also known as half.
Is this 4/4?
Yes, this means full. Now you must have understood that 1/4 is 1/4. 3/4 is 3/4. Yes, right. Now let's look at some more examples to clear this misconception. Father of Bimla and Chandu has bought a packet of candy. It contains 40 candies. Now look at this pie chart to find out how many candies have been eaten by the kids.
They ate 1/4, that is 1/4 of the candies. So, 1/4 of 40 is 10. So, children ate 10 candies.
So, how many candies are left?
3/4, that is 30 candies.
Very good. Today, while coming to school, students got drenched in rain. Now, can you tell, has more than half of the students got drenched by the rain?
Yes, more than half of the students got drenched in the rain, as 3/4 students got drenched.
Very good. So, I am hoping now your doubt has been cleared regarding the misconception of 1/4 and 3/4 being equal.